Hello everyone, welcome back to Playa Rupa, and in this video, I want to share to you how to make a foggy look in webtoon background. Alright, before we get into this tutorial, I need to say thank you for you all because I already got a 1901 views in my previous webtoon tutorial, and that is so amazing to me because as me, as the very small YouTuber, just 83 subscribers, and this is so amazing to me. And I will share all I knew about the webtoon tutorial, and I will tell to you because this is so fun to share all of my knowledge to everyone. And so let's get started. Alright, right now I already had some kind of a model of a house. As you can see, this is not really that detailed, but you have to make sure again you already put some kind of a material on all of your buildings and your surface. For example, in here I already had a grass material, and about the wall, the bricks, even the car. Alright then, let's get into the next step. First, we need to go to edit menu, a view menu actually, and we turn on the shadow and the fog. So turn on the shadows and turn on the fog. Okay, as you can see, this is already a fog here. And before we go to the settings about the shadows and the fog, we need to make sure the fixed view you want to make it into the background. All right now maybe I need to some kind of this range, and I recommend to turn on the 2-point perspective, just like this. Okay, kind of that. And the next step is to change this shadow. Maybe I need to a little bit more, like not this time. You can just choose all of the time zone you want. Maybe this is already good, and I need to some kind of a really not that evening. I need to just a morning view, maybe about 9 o'clock and past 42 maybe. And about this date, you can just choose whatever you want. Maybe I just choose this date. And about the light, I need to a little bit more about the light, maybe 82. And about the dark, I need to a little bit more feel about this, maybe 39. All right this is good. Oh, I think I need to just uncheck this use sun for shading. Okay, this view is already good. And the next step is we need to make new 3 scenes. Alright, we can just click this add scene button and 1, 2, and 3. Alright then. 1, 2, 3. Oh, I think this is the first. Maybe I need to make this, I need to rename this first because this is already really confusing. So I need to just make this texture, and this one is edges, and the last one is the shade. Alright then, first we need to go to this texture scene, double click and wait for a minute, and then we need to make this about the settings. And so we need to go to styles, and I think this style is already good. And about the edit, maybe I need to make this check on edges. Oh no, I need to uncheck this, and we can see this is already the texture only, so this is already good. So make sure this is already updated. Alright, the next step is we need to go to edges scene, double click. After we make sure the edges already selected, we can just go to settings style. First we need to go to change the style about this look. I need to choose the hidden line, this one, and then go to edit. And about this settings is already good, but the important thing is we need to uncheck the shadows because this is an edges scene. We uncheck this and voila. So we can go to scenes again, and we can just update the scene. a bit. Alright, this is already good. So the last one is the shade sin. We just go and double click this, and we go back to the really first thing about the texture, and we need to change it. So we need to go to styles again, and we need to go to select and choose the hidden line again. About this, we can just go to edit and make sure this is already good. So, and make sure the shadows is on. Alright, this is an opposite before this, because this is a shadow scene, maybe the shade scene, so it is the same. So alright, then after that we need to go to scenes again, and this one we need to make this update about the all the changes we made. So we click update, wait a second, and it is already done. So the next step is we need to import all of these three scenes into the PNG. First is texture, we need to go to file and click export into 2D graphic. And I prefer to choose become to PNG. I need to make this house text export. After that, we need to go to edge scene, double click. We need to export it again into 2D graphic as PNG and name it to an edge. Okay, here we go, the last one, double click and go to export 2D graphic and change the name about the shade. Okay, we already done. So we need to go to the Photoshop. Alright, right now we need to open the Photoshop, and we need to reopen those three files that we've made before: the texture, the shade, and the edges. After these files already opened, we need to drag them into one place. For example, in here, I need to make the texture as the base, and then I need to drag the edges into the texture like this. And then the shape, we need to move it into the texture as well. After that, I think I need to rename this into the right layer. For example, this texture and this edges, and this one is shade. Alright, we need to arrange this like this, the texture, the edges, and the shade. So the next step is we need to change the settings about each one of this layer. And about the texture, I need to just leave it like this. And about the edges, I need to change this into the color burnt and change the opacity into 40%. And the fill is about 40% as well. And about the shade, I think I need to change it into maybe the multiply, and change the opacity is about 50%, and the fill about 50% as well. Alright, this is already good. And I think I need some kind of dim light. You know, this is still in the morning. First, I need to add a new layer, and the next step is we need to change the color into maybe the yellow one, really yellow, and then select the brush, and oh, maybe I need to a really, really small size of brush. Okay, that I think that's enough, and I need to make a dot in those lamps. Okay, make sure the layer is selected and make a dot. Oh, and make sure the opacity and flow is 100%. Make a dot. Okay, and in here as well, this one too, and all of the lamps, and this last one. Alright then, okay, right now I need to change the style about this layer, maybe about the older glow. Maybe I need to make the spread is about really high and change the size as well. Maybe you can just arrange this all you want. Alright, I think that's enough. Maybe just a little bit more. Then. Alright, I think that's enough. Alright, I hope this video is useful. You can click the share button and let all the future author out there know this tutorial. So check out my Instagram and tell me about more what is it you want to do with your webtoon or tutorial. Let me know in the comment below. Or maybe you can ask me in the Twitter. So, bye then.